Hey, welcome to another episode of geekoutdoors.com. Today I'm going to be talking about two really cool tools that I just started using, and both of them are available in your software manager. So the first tool that I want to talk about is glances, okay? And then this is available, like I said, in the software manager. You could just go ahead and install it there. So let me tell you what this tool is about. Now, typically, if we want to know what's going on our computer quickly, I'll usually use the built-in system monitor. This gives me a really quick snapshot of what's going on, my CPU usage, memory, and so forth, and also the processes that are running, including how much space is being used. Now, I think for the majority of people, including myself, this is more than enough for you to get an idea of what's going on in your system. However, people who use Linux quite heavily, especially people who use the command line and servers, they'll probably use something on the terminal itself. You know, the most basic one is using the top command, which will actually show you in general at a high level that what's going on, including all the processes. Okay, so the system monitor pretty much pulls the information from something like this. Okay, but now that we've installed the tool Glances, it actually offers you more information. So once you've installed Glances, okay, through the software manager, it won't show up here at all. Okay, this is actually only going to be run through your terminal. Okay, so if you type in Glances, now you get something like this. Okay, so it's better if it's a little larger, maybe just make it full screen. So this gives you a lot more information quicker, and it's also easier to see. And so as you can see here, you could see all your processes that are running. You could see your CPU usage as well, networking, disk I/O, actual space used up on your file system, swap space, memory, the amount of load on your actual CPU as well. And it'll give you other information down here if there's anything critical running. And also if you press H, there's even more quick key features. You just press the actual character and it'll show you a bunch of different information. Okay, so any of these right here, you could sort a lot of information. You could view a lot of different things right here, and it's super simple to use. So if I press H again, it'll go back here. See, and then depending on which shortcut, see, like right there, I press I and now it's sorted by IO, and you can press that again. And here's D, disk system. Okay, so it allows you to quickly see what's going on and the most important things going on your computer. I think this is a great tool. I prefer a GUI tool if available. I will probably more than likely use this more than anything else. However, if you want to quickly get a snapshot and really easily readable versus something like Top, this is an excellent tool. And once you get used to looking at this information and using the various hotkeys that are here, it makes it super easy to use. And so this is probably one of the best monitoring tools that I've actually used in terms of ease of use and also the information that is provided. Okay, so that is the first tool. The second tool is something that I've had a challenge with for many, many years, and that is typing. And so the name of the tool is called Klavaro. So you type this in, and this is an awesome tool. Okay, it's just like it is, says right here, it's a typing tutor. That's what it is. It teaches you how to type. So once you install it, you'll find it under education. And what I like about this tool is it is super simple. Okay, there's pretty much four main categories here, and you could choose various types of keyboards, okay, various styles, and obviously different languages. But you also have this speech feature, which you could turn on and off, a dictation mode, and I'll show you how this works, okay? So if you go to the introduction, it really gives you a high level, but something that is very important to when you're typing, you know, talking about the position of your fingers, okay, and why it is important that these are the ones that you're actually going to use. And as basic as this sounds, for somebody who is learning how to use the keyboard, these are key things that you need to learn, okay? And so when you actually get into the course, like I said, there's really four categories, but these are actually the courses right here, okay? So actually there's five different sections, but there's actually really only four courses. And so most of it works the same. So check this out right here. Normally, whenever you start a course, I already started this one, but you could hear the actual voice right there, the dictation, okay? And here's the course information. It tells you what's going on in this course. You could also look at your progress as well. And you could even move across different parts of the lessons, okay? You could even reset it as well, okay? So if I typed in, see, this reminds me of a computer back in the 70s or 80s because of the dictation. But you could turn this off, but I think it's just really cool that it tells you what to press. See, and so it's very, very simple. However, it's extremely effective. As I'm going through here, it gets a lot, obviously, a lot more complex. But as you are using this more and more, you get better. Okay, you just get a lot better. And you could even turn on this beeping noise as well if you do make a mistake. So, excellent typing tool. I really highly recommend this. I'm going to really try to get better at typing. So I'm going to be using this tool a lot more because, you know, typing programs, they're not always that great in my opinion, you know, but something like this where it is easy to use and I could actually see some improvements in my typing, I'm really impressed by it. And so that is it for this episode on these two really cool tools that I found through the Linux Software Manager. So the first one is Glances right here, which will allow you to quickly see the most important things going on with your system. So then the second one is Klavaro, probably one of the best and easiest to use typing tutors that I've actually used myself. And so if you had any thoughts on these two tools or any other tools that you enjoy using in Linux, be sure to leave that in the comments area below. And so as always, if you did enjoy these videos, you got value out of them, be sure to subscribe. And if you wanted to support my channel further, you could do that at patreon.com/geekoutdoors. Thanks for checking out this episode. And as always, if you like these videos, be sure to click on the subscribe button. And for full written content, audio content, and additional geek stuff, head over to geekoutdoors.com, and I'll see you outdoors on the very next episode.